Hello again, I'm Mike Mazzalongo, and this is the Bible Talk video blog. Today's blog entry is entitled Spiritual Security. Well, there's been a lot of talk concerning Social Security that has a lot of folks in a lather. The government is suggesting a variety of ways to save it or make it more viable. Some groups want to abolish it in favor of private plans. Others suggest delaying retirement or having part of the Social Security payments put into private funds. With the bulk of the population rapidly approaching retirement, it's natural that people are feeling a little panicky. Now the problem, of course, is the name of the program, not the lack of money. Social Security implies that society, real people, provide for their own safety. Now there's a scary thought. No wonder everybody is worried. Our future is in the shaky hands of mere mortals with a poor track record. In addressing this natural concern of people for their personal welfare, Jesus said, "Do not be anxious then, saying, 'What shall we eat?' or 'What shall we drink?' but seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all of these things shall be added to you." Matthew chapter 6, verse 31 and 33. God's solution for America in the year 2020, when Social Security is supposed to crash, is the same as it's always been. Search to do God's will and let Him provide each day's need one day at a time. Of course, let's invest our money wisely, but realize that without God's blessing, there would be no money to invest, no dividends in return, no plan whatsoever. This generation needs to decide into whose hands they will place their future. Social Security may provide basic needs as long as you live. However, spiritual security will provide for all of your needs in this life and guarantee eternal life as a tax-free bonus. Well, I'm Mike Mazzalongo, and you've been listening to the Bible Talk video blog. We'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.